Good afternoon, everyone. We're kindly silent all your phones as we're about to start. Please remain seated as we welcome the bridal entourage. Please all stand to welcome the bride.
the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Well, dear friends, and especially, of course, dear Miguel and Gia, God is love and has in mysterious ways drawn you together in love. But he leaves you free to make that grow or let it wither and die. The Lord will always be with you. He will help you to forge a future for your love. But you also have to do your share. And you do this when you stand to the commitment that you make today to love and honor one another in good times and in bad, in poverty and plenty, in sickness and health, for better and for worse, in this commitment and covenant which you're about to seal. And so, brothers and sisters, parents, friends, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us begin by calling to mind our failings and ask the Lord for pardon and for healing. We pray together. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that
I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to our Lord, our God.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. No, sorry. Recite the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. We bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these your servants, Miguel and Gia, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Let us now listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. If I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Set your hearts on the greater gifts. Now I will show you the way which surpasses all the others. If I speak with human tongues and angelic as well, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong, a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and with full knowledge, comprehend all mysteries, if I have faith great enough to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give everything I have to feed the poor and hand over my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. Love is not jealous, it does not put on airs. It is not snobbish. Love is never rude, it is not self-seeking. It is not prone to anger, neither does it brood over injuries. Love does not rejoice in what is wrong, but rejoices with the truth. There is no limit to love's forbearance, to its truth, its hope, its power to endure. Love never fails. Prophecies will cease, tongues will be silent, knowledge will pass away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, the earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
The earth is full of the goodness, of,
the goodness of the Lord.
Happy the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. Response, the earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. But see, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness. Response:
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. For in him our hearts rejoice, in his holy name we trust. Response:
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us who have put our hope in you. Response:
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Please stand to honor the Holy Gospel.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Live on in my love. You will live in my love if you keep my commandments, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and live in his love. All this I tell you, that your joy may My joy may be yours, and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment: love one another as I have loved you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the homily.
So Miguel and Gia, we're finally here. We've talked about this for a long time, and we're very happy to see you finally come together on this your wedding day. Your family and friends, all of us, I guess there will be more except for all the rules of the IATF, join you in this wonderful day, a day truly that the Lord has made, to celebrate the beginning of your living one life together. In the story of Tobit and Sarah in the Old Testament, God sent his angel Raphael to accompany Tobit on his journey and to bring him and Sarah together. I'm sure when you look back over the journey that has brought you together, you will see and feel the hand of God. In so many people, friends, family, college batchmates, and in the many events, maybe some seemingly accidental, that was God's angel Raphael coming to bring you together. So as we prayed at the beginning of the Mass, God is love and has, in mysterious and not always mysterious ways, drawn you together in love. Today, in the days to come and years to come, I invite you to take time to reflect and pray on the mysterious comings of God which have brought you together. Because the meaning of today is not just today, but all the graces, the events, the people that have brought you together this day. They are part of our celebration. They are part of our thanks today. I actually had an email exchange with Gia about your unity candle. I know it's part often of a wedding ceremony, but I had never thought much about it, about that part of the wedding ceremony. But reflecting on it, it is a practice very full of meaning. Before we begin the ceremony of your exchange of vows, your candle sponsors will light your individual candles over here. And symbols of your individual lives till now. After your commitment to be one heart and one soul, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, you will light the unity candle. I don't know where it is, I guess somebody will bring it. You will together light your unity candle, affirming that your two lives symbolized by the two other candles have become one. This is what marriage has meant from the beginning of creation. In the story of our first parents Adam and Eve in Genesis, as well as the stories of Tobit and Sarah, it is always affirmed that husband and wife become one person, one flesh, one in love. At the wedding of my eldest niece, Michelle, 20 years ago, they quoted an Apache love poem, which captures beautifully what you're becoming one today means and feels. You probably know it, but I think it symbolizes what you're coming together is. The poem goes this way. It says, "Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there is no more loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two bodies, but there is one life before you. There is one life before you. Today, however, is only the beginning of your journey together, together in one life. Though you have lit the unity candles, you will have lit the unity candle for your individual candles, you will still remain individuals, actually. You will still be yourselves. And so, to be shelter to the other, warmth to the other, companion to the other, is not a once for all, it's a journey. It's a journey, and as your parents and other couples here will tell you, it is a journey of a lifetime. It's a journey of loving each other and growing together in love. And so, I think that's what our first reading from St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians tells us. It tells us what love means. The love that will ensure that you grow together in commitment, the commitment you make to each other. I think when we met, I told you that you will continue to grow individually, and you have to ensure that you grow together. I said, have a date at least once a week of one another. So that you affirm, really, that you will continue to work together to become one in heart and mind. In the Paul's letter to the Corinthians, he tells us that love is kind, love is patient. He says love is not jealous, it is not prone to anger, it does not brood over injuries. But of course we know that love can be very jealous. And we know that we can get angry, and we know we can get hurt and injured. But the point is to reach out and connect to one another. Pope Francis says there is no perfect family, no perfect husband and wife, but he says a healthy family, you should use frequently three phrases. May I, thank you, I am sorry, and he says, never, 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 he really said it right, end the day without making peace. This, of course, is not easy. In our own vocation as priests, we too have to go through a journey of living out our vocation and commitment. And yeah, we can get, maybe not jealous, but we can get angry, we can get impatient, we can be irritated. But just as with you, we learn in time that, yeah, just be sorry immediately. Do not let the day pass without reconciling. So St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians really tells you what is the love in your journey to become the husband and wife, the family that God wants you to be and to become. And of course, the assurance that you will make it is because Jesus will accompany you. He promises in our gospel, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Live on in my love. And we know he loved us to the end. He loved us to death. He loved us with all that he could give. We know that the love of Jesus has always been patient with us. We are aware of our shortcomings. I'm very aware of mine. But he has always been kind and merciful to me, and I'm sure he has been to you. He overlooks our failures and our stumbling. He only asks that we turn to him for forgiveness. It is his love that assures you that you will have the grace to live out fully and generously the commitment that you make today to one another, to the family that God will give you, to your families, to your friends, and to all who will enter and touch your lives. And so, you learned in your course, maybe under Father Dakanay, that marriage is a sacrament. Your marriage and your family is a sacrament, a sign, a sign. A sign of God's love and fidelity in the world. We live in a world where people are afraid of commitment very often, where people say lifetime commitment is not possible. But precisely the fidelity that you will give in your family life is a witness that, yeah, God's fidelity is forever, and it is possible for us also to live out our fidelity throughout our lives. And so therefore, you will then have a caring and a loving family, which will be a great gift to our country and to our world. Our world, which is in great need of faithfulness, of commitment, and love. Friends, you have come. So, Miguel and Gia, you have together come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and his community. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Gia, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your husband?
Yes, Father.
Miguel, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your wife?
Yes, Father.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Okay, so since this is your intention to enter into marriage, please join your right hands. You can still raise your hand. And declare your consent before God and his church. Gia, do you take Miguel here present for your lawful husband, according to the right of our Holy Mother, the Church?
I do.
Do you give yourself to him as his wife?
I do.
Do you accept him as your lawful husband?
I do.
Miguel, do you accept Gia here present for your lawful wife according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
I do.
Do you give yourself to her as your husband?
I do.
Do you accept her as your lawful wife?
I do.
And now you have your own personal wife.
Gia, God couldn't wait any longer for me to meet my soulmate, so he brought you into this world a few hours after I was born into this world, in the same hospital. We probably lay beside each other for a few hours when God decided for us to grow. 18 years later, when we were finally adults, he brought us back together. What a crazy journey it has been. From victories to defeats, we've experienced it all. Off the court, when success didn't seem too achievable for me, you stayed. Failures, you stayed. Clipped wings, you still stayed. And all of the trials so far, and you still decided to stay. You proved to me that love is not about being the best, it's about seeing the best. And when I asked God to give me strength, he gave me you. When I asked God for patience, He gave me a year of courting you. And when I asked God to bless me with what He knows is best for me, I saw you walking up the building. You are God's blessing to me, Gia, and there are no words to express, no numbers to quantify, and no ways to measure that. You are the proof that God's love overflows. I will not be perfect and I will never be, but I promise to always love you the way God has taught me to. If blessed, I promise to love our children. I promise to bring them closer to God with your help. And I promise to always choose you. Always. And lastly, I promise to keep you safe, loved, and fed through good times, bad times, and nap times. I love you.
God gave me a love story so much greater than I could ever imagine for myself. I was born on May 10, 1995 at 7:09 p.m. Little did I know that almost 11 hours earlier, on the same day, in the same hospital, the man I'm so extremely blessed to have standing here with me today was born. With that, plus 7 years of knowing each other and being together, I can say with 100% certainty that today I'm marrying my soulmate. Miguel, I feel inevitably linked to you and unbelievably blessed by that. Because in your love, I felt God's love. Love that is strong, pure, constant, and unconditional. So today, as we surrender our relationship to God, I make these vows to you. I vow to take on adventures with you and be your food trip and road trip partner for life, even when I'm always asleep in the car. I vow to laugh at your corny jokes, most especially when no one else in the room is laughing. I vow to be the person you inspire me to be and the person you deserve. To be patient and to remember that all things between us are rooted in love. I promise to respect you as a person with your own interests, dreams, and needs, and to recognize that those are sometimes different but no less important than my own. I promise that no matter what, especially through the pressures of the present and the uncertainties of the future, you will always have me beside you, supporting you and believing in you as your wife, your partner, and your best friend. Giving you all of my strength and my words when needed, and to share in the silence when they are not. I promise to live in truth with you and to communicate with you fully and fearlessly. I promise to put our marriage and family first, never taking our love and time for granted, and making sure we are constantly working to grow together. I promise to always remind you how much God loves you and encourage you to trust in God's awareness of whatever situation we are in so that we can take comfort in His plan, which I know will unfold in His will and perfect time, just like today. And I promise to love you however, whatever, whenever, under any circumstance and without hesitation. Because from this moment on, every single day, I will choose you. Because you are and always will be my person. Please know that your heart will always be safe with me. Miguel, I love you.
And so, Miguel and Gia, we have heard your commitment to each other. We pray that the Lord will be there to support you with it.
Good Grant us, O Lord, to be one heart and soul from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
And I, by the authority of the Church, calling on all those present here as witnesses, confirm and bless the bond of marriage which you have contracted in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now have the rings again. So, Miguel and Gia, we shall now bless your array and your rings. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, your servants, Miguel and Gia, with sufficiency of material possessions, which this array symbolizes, so that they may use them to attain eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bless, O Lord, these rings, so that your servants, Miguel and Gia, who wear them, may ever live in mutual love, in an unbroken loyalty, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Also bless your Bible. Bless, O Lord, this holy Bible, which symbolizes your presence among us. May this Bible inspire Miguel and Gia to live an exemplary Christian life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Julia, wear this ring as a sign of my love and loyalty. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Miguel, wear this ring as a sign of my love and loyalty. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Julia, I gave you these array as a pledge of my dedication to your welfare. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
And I accept them.
Miguel and Gia, accept this Holy Bible for you to read, learn, and live as your guide in your daily life through Christ our Lord. And so, my dear friends, let me present to you our new couple, Miguel and Julia Guzman. Thank you. Congratulations.
Please all rise for the prayers of the faithful.
My dear friends, let us now pray for the church and for our newly wedded couple, Miguel and Julia, whose marriage reflects the church's union with Christ. We say, Lord, graciously hear us.
For the Holy Church spread throughout the world, for its leaders and for the rulers of our nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the poor and the sick and all those in trial and affliction, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For Miguel and Julia, that they may keep their hearts united forever, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That he may protect them from evil, lighten their burdens, and fortify them in their trials, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Almighty eternal God, look down with favor upon your servants Miguel and Julia. Grant them to remain faithful to you and to one another. At the end of a long and well-spent life, reward them with eternal happiness, together with all those who love them, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. The veil and cord sponsors may now place the veil and the cord over the couple, after which we shall have the presentation of the gifts. Let us all rise.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Your goodness we have this bread to offer, which thou hast given and human hands have made, to become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, through your goodness, serve this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
My brothers and sisters, pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that just as you have redeemed man and woman with the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you might make them partakers of divine nature and joint heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more deeply into the wondrous design of your love. And so with the angels and all the saints, we praise you, and without end, we acclaim. Holy.
Holy, holy, holy Lord of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Let us all stand.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Honesto, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Be mindful also of Miguel and Julia, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love and peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and with all the saints, we have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Turn to our Father and pray to him with confidence in the words our Savior taught us.
Ama namin, sumasalangit ka, sambahin ang alan mo. Sa amin ang kaharian mo, sundin ang loob mo dito sa lupa para
kami ipahin tulad sa tukso. At yadya mo kami sa lahat ng masama.
My dear friends, let us pray to the Lord for this bride and groom who come to, come to the altar as they begin their married life, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, they may be always bound together by love for one another. Holy Father, who formed man in your own image, male and female you created them, so that as husband and wife, united in body and heart, they might fulfill their calling in the world. O God, who to reveal the great design you formed in your love, will that the love of spouses for each other should foreshadow the covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfillment of the sacramental sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with his church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your right hand over these your servants, Miguel and Julia, we pray, and pour into their hearts the power of the Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, that as they enter upon this sacramental union, they may share with one another the gifts of your love, and by being for each other a sign of your presence, become one heart and one mind. May they also sustain, O Lord, by their deeds the home they are forming, and prepare their children to become members of your heavenly household by raising them in the way of the gospel. Graciously crown with your blessings your daughter Julia, so that by being a good wife and nurturing mother, she may bring warmth to her home with a love that is pure and adorn it with welcoming graciousness. Bestow a heavenly blessing also, O Lord, on Miguel, your servant, that he may be a worthy, good, and faithful husband and a provident father. Grant, Holy Father, that desiring to approach your table as a couple joined in marriage in your presence, they may come one day to have the joy of partaking in your great banquet in heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be God. Peace be God.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Let us all kneel.
This is the Lamb of God. This is he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jesus,
Sponsors may now remove the cord in the veil.
Let us rise for our final prayer and blessing. You may rise. Let us pray. Having been made partakers at your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united with the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Miguel and Julia, now that you have received the holy sacrament of matrimony, I admonish you to remain faithful to one another, as you promised. Julia, love your husband and be a good wife. Persevere in faith, love, and holiness. Miguel, love your wife as Christ loves his church, his people. and live with her in the holy fear of the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you his joy and bless you in your children.
Amen.
May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God always pour his love into your hands.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We have celebrated the sacrament of God's faithful love. Go and be faithful in love for one another.
Thanks be to God.
And we present to you our couple again, Mr. and Mrs. Miguel de Guzman. And Miguel, you may kiss the bride.
Please all be seated while the bride, the groom, the... All be seated while the bride, the groom, the priest, and the sponsor sign the marriage contract. All be seated while the bride, the groom, the priest, and the sponsor sign the marriage contract. Thank you.
of the groom, please join our couple. Parents of the groom, please. Parents of Miguel. Relatives of Miguel, please get ready. Family and relatives of the groom, please. All the family and relatives of Miguel, please come forward. Both parents, please. Parents of Miguel and parents of Gia, please come forward. Parents of our bride and groom. The groom may now be seated. Parents of the bride, please stay. Siblings of the bride, please get ready. May we have the siblings of Gia, please? Parents and siblings, please. Relatives of the bride, please get ready. Have the relatives of the bride, please. Family and relatives of the bride, please come forward. Family and relatives of the bride, please come forward. Here we have the best man and the maid of honor. Secondary sponsors, please get ready. Cord, veil, and candle sponsors, you'll be next. Cord, veil, and candle sponsors, please. Groomsmen and bridesmaids, please be ready. Groomsmen and bridesmaids, please come forward. Principal sponsors, please get ready. Best man, maid of honor, please join the pictorial also. Principal sponsors, please join our couple. Ninongs and Ninangs, kindly join our couple in front. Entourage, done with the pictorial, kindly line up at the center aisle for our recessional. After the principal sponsors, we'll have the friends of the couple for the pictorial. Have the friends of the couple. All the friends of the couple, please. All the friends of the couple, please come in front. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now may we request our entourage, best man, maid of honor, secondary sponsors, groomsmen and bridesmaids, and their principal sponsors to kindly line up with your partners at the center aisle for our recessional, as well as our parents of the couple. Thank you. For the rest of the guests, we can now all wait outside the church for our couple. Thanks. Thank you.
heart natin.